Alright guys, so today I'm using a different reel than I normally do. This is the bait cast, and I've used it a couple times, but I gotta get used to it now. It's a this is a pretty tough one to use, to get used to anyways at first. But we also have to just use artificial bait, which we're not super used to. We've had trouble in the past using artificial bait, but we're gonna see how it goes today.
Yeah, I have a feeling we aren't gonna get much, but
we'll see.
There's only one way to find out, really. Oh.
Wow.
Almost crossed the line there, but
we almost crossed the line. All right, I'm gonna go fishing.
Yeah, fish on.
Fish on already?
Wait. Or maybe we did cross the line.
Yeah,
okay. Fossil line.
Yep, he got a fish.
Alright, guys, it looks like I got a crappie, and check it out. It was on my line. It's so small that I thought I was getting a nibble, but then I got a little fish. The first and possibly the only fish of the day, so.
No, I'm gonna catch more.
Yeah, actually, this put some more hope in me, but I'm glad it bit. But look at this. That's a big bait for such a little fish, don't you think?
Yeah.
Anyway, that's the catch I'm gonna...
Alrighty.
I'm gonna let him go right here.
Okay.
There he goes.
And there goes Bessie.
Got my fish.
Oh.
Okay.
Hi. Just got me here a snake. Not exactly sure what kind, but pretty sure it's some type of water snake. As I did find it in the water, but that's not the only sign, but definitely looks like water snake.
We'll be sure and identify it when we get home. But
one of my bigger snakes, probably second biggest. Pretty nice snake. Really docile. And pretty excited right now, so.
Caught a snake at Kids Lake. Don't want to shake, just want a snake.
It's really healthy snake, too. Look at the.
I think it's unhealthy. It looks like it's been to Dairy Queen. Dairy Queen too much. Let me get a closer look at it. Hope the fish bite. If they don't. Then we won't eat tonight. Right?
Oh, spider.
What'd you get?
Got me a bluegill.
I think there's some water pressure.
Yeah, so.
No, I'll just get him.
Okay, guys, this is the patent pending.
Oh, that's a big bluegill.
Just kidding.
Yeah, nice.
I've just not finished that thought.
That could be the top five biggest bluegill I've ever seen.
Okay.
It's a big one.
Are we gonna eat him?
I don't know.
Watch the spiders.
Button. Let's just try him. Let's take a little
Wait,
bite.
I want to get this on
camera.
I think
we're gonna use him for bait because he's pretty bad.
That one's too big for bait. I would get a small
one. It's kind of a lot of bait.
No, you could chop him up or something. Look at all the blood, though.
Got him pretty good with that hook.
Wait, hold it up for the camera to see it. Steven.
I'm getting it. Right.
So, pretty nice fish here for a bluegill.
Yeah, use the lip grabber.
Alright, the lip
Wait,
grabber.
Wait, no, don't, because his lip is torn up. It's torn apart.
The ultimate lip grabber.
I'll just hold him like this.
No, hold him by the lip.
Well, the upper lip?
No, if it falls off, it's spot. Okay.
Well, no, okay. Fish lips actually, they'll just heal up real fast. They're pretty resilient.
Got a nice little dude.
Yeah.
So, I don't know if I want to release
We'll use the lip grabbers on the next one because Steven isn't manly enough.
I am the official lip grabber
person
guy.
unless it's your fish, then I will do the honor.
Yeah.
All right. I just
gave him.
All right.
That was a wow.
So I'm excited that I just caught this awesome snake, but I'm also a little disappointed because I almost caught with a net. I don't know where it went, but we have this net, and I almost caught these two. They're probably 2 foot long. Guards about this. And they were, I think they're a short nose gar, or no, I mean long nose gar, and they were right up on the shore, and there was a few of them. They were trying to mate, almost caught a couple of them, but unfortunately I didn't, but I think it's awesome. I almost just caught 2 big gars, and we're going to keep fishing, keep searching. Oh, it's good.
Yeah, just a little fish.
It's a big one.
A big fish. I've caught many fish, and this is one of the biggest.
Hey, what kind is this?
Okay,
is this smallmouth?
Not one of the biggest. Never mind.
Oh, let's get the lip grabber. I am the honor. Lip grabber.
It's a nice fish, but it's
a
actually,
nice.
He's pretty mean.
All right, let's unhook that.
Yeah, mean.
Now this is a bass, so we are gonna need to catch and release. Dad, Gabe caught a bass.
Catch and release, fish.
Well, it's got a difficult hole to get. It's fine. It's okay. But Steven caught, well, I caught it, but it's on Steven's reel. So if he was over here, he would have caught this massive fish, but I caught it. It was a fight to behold.
So tell us part of the process in catching such a behemoth in these waters.
Are you talking to me?
Actually, yes, I was. So tell us.
We need something to, Dad, do we have pliers? Okay, good. We got pliers. Well, the key is you gotta go grab the pliers.
Trying to zoom in here.
Oh, and he just went the other way.
Not sure if there's
okay,
a zoom
right.
in function.
The
though.
Process in catching one of these big heifers is you first have a 4 or 5 hour battle with it, and then by the time you're both exhausted, you catch it and then get the fish grabbers out.
Is that what happened?
Yeah. Well, I exaggerated, but...
Well, we're fishermen.
Yeah, fishermen always exaggerate.
We're teaching you guys.
Teaching you a lesson.
An exaggeration.
Alright. I'm gonna go try and grab it.
I'm just gonna see if any guts come out with this hook. Ooh. There may be some guts coming out with this hook. Whoa!
Got it.
Is the fish gonna bleed internally and die?
I don't know.
Did you keep your bass?
Filming commenced. Well, guys, caught a catfish. Philip's noodling him right now. He already is bleeding a little bit from the catfish's bite. Whoa!
And his spines are about to kill me.
Catfish are dangerous. This is a tiny little guy. Got our special grabbers. He's a tiny little guy, and Philip is bleeding just from the bite of him.
Yep. Alright, so. Just a little guy. Wait, aim the camera. Yeah.
You're dripping in my tackle box.
This fish may be dead.
Okay. Back in the bucket.
So, what do you have to say about this? Fish.
I have to say that between...
Uh-oh, our fishing reds
oh,
are
yeah,
getting
I think that's it. We need to
wet.
Bucket.
Don't kick the bucket.
I have to say that those catfish and stripers put up the best fight out of any fish I've ever caught.
Were you screaming when you caught this fish?
Yeah, I was yelling. No, I wasn't.
So we got here some stuff. So here's the story. I was fishing. And then this fish kept nibbling on my bobber, my hook, my bait. So he was nibbling on it, I thought. So it kept bobbing around every once in a while. So then after a while, he stopped. So I decided, well, let's reel it in. So I reeled it in, and I thought, well, he must still be on there just being really calm because it was heavy. Then I pull it up, and there's a stick, and I'm like, oh, stink, it's just heavy because I caught a stick. But then after the stick came up a fish, and that'd be this guy who had, fortunately, has passed away from the hook, so we're probably going to use him as bait now. But I also looked at the stick and found a little critter that you don't want to come across. This guy here is a leech, which is quite creepy indeed, but I've also heard that they're good bait, so that's what's up. I caught us some bait, so that's nice, so we're going to use it. Awesome.
Okay.
Let's try to get better line.
Awesome banded water snake. I actually got bit because he struck back. And that's why you identify the snakes before you catch them, because they can easily strike back like that.
But awesome, he's a cool snake. Totally worth it, right?
Yep. Bill? And look at my catfish finger.
Not sure. You can't see
it. It's really stiff. I can't hardly even move that.
Yep, Philip's been torn up today.
I've been bitten by a catfish and a snake.
Pretty awesome. Add to a collection of bites. Look, I can scare him with my shadow. There we go.
There we go. Go, go, go. There he goes. The water snake in the water.
I think he likes the light, maybe.
Hey, gone.
Awesome. Hey, gone. Ready?
You ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready.
As long as the video and light is ready, let's do it, dude. Alright, let's dump the fish. Alright, we decided not to keep any fish, so we're gonna dump them out.
Didn't catch enough to keep.
That one looks lively.
Yeah, it needs waking up.
Ooh, oh, nice, there's a catfish. Sorry about the shadow. Only three were in there?
Yep.
Yeah. That's all I had.
Yeah, the catfish is...
Catfish is good.
Five fish, because we released two.
I think the bluegill are dead.
No, go towards the middle
catfish
of the lake.
Catfish always do that.
It's a little disoriented.
Yeah, very disoriented.
There he goes, under that ledge.
That should help him.
Well, it looked like then he went...
Alright, Gabe, wake these things up.